I've walked this path, having to reinvent myself after divorce. I know it's not an easy thing, and there's probably 100 thoughts running through your head at this very moment about what life will be like on the other side of what you thought it would. And I think before any reinventing can ultimately happen, we've really got to be sure we don't skip over the grieving part. The really facing the emotions and the experiences of the letdown of the relationship. Considering you thought your life was going to go one way, and now you're having to redesign it from a place of choice, from a place of learning, but that doesn't mean that it's easy. And so I think if we try to reinvent over top of the pain, we might end up creating more of the same, meaning bringing in a partner that seems very similar to our past partner. Instead of his name being Bill, it's now Chris. We want to be sure we're catching the undercurrents, the learning from the relationship, so that we don't bring the same pain forward. That's just one aspect of the reinventing. Right now, you might be thinking, another relationship, that's the last thing on my mind. And that's okay if that's where you're at. We still want to look at, how did I show up in the relationship? What parts of myself did I compromise? And how might I like to change how I show up? Not only in intimate, loving relationships, but in my friendships too. That's actually a great place to start to practice. Where you might notice you give yourself away for connection, where you might hive off a part of who you naturally are just in order to fit. The ability to practice being more authentic, more of who you truly are, whether the other person is uncomfortable with it or unsure about it, more of that will help you to get back into your center, back into this place of who you really are. What if you could embrace who you are now on the other side of this relationship? Whenever we deeply love someone, it fundamentally changes us. We can't really go back to the person we were before. We dedicated all that time and energy with that person. And that can be a positive thing. Beginning to question, who am I now after this relationship? What parts of me have grown? What have I learned about myself in love? And who would I like to become from that place? It's a real position of strength. It's a real place of inquiry. And it really helped me a lot when I was redefining who am I now on the other side of this divorce. A really big piece for me was a shift in perception that this divorce was a failure. My marriage was complete. We were together almost a decade. Gosh, I learned a lot about myself in that time, but perhaps never more than at the time of separation. It was such a deep dive into what went wrong, into who I am now, all the things I was just sharing with you. And now I was at this place of what's possible from here. I've walked the very path you're on right now, having to reinvent myself after divorce. At a time where I felt the most shaky, my confidence was definitely in pieces on the floor, and having to really consider what did I want for my life now, moving forward. It was a super intense time, which I'm sure you can relate to. But the importance of placing our focus here, instead of really letting those big, intense emotions swallow us whole, allows for something good, allows the divorce to be like fertilizer, to grow the most beautiful flowers and the healthiest vegetables that can nourish your new life. And so let me share with you a few of the things that worked for me in hopes that they can have the same positive effect for you. A really big element was starting to take a look at who I am now on the other side of that divorce. What changed in me inside of that long-term relationship? What did I learn about myself? How did I love? How did I navigate that separation? How did I understand more of my natural needs that were just a part of me in a loving relationship? How could I really get to know the me in dysfunctional love? Because that's what it was. And how did I navigate my way out of it? When I really looked with pure focus, It's like I uncovered gold about myself, about my early life experiences, about how I learned to love inside of my family, and how I ended up repeating a lot of that pain. We really didn't know how to love each other in a healthy way. His patterns and mine tended to clash, and we ended up hurting each other in those very unique places that only someone really close to you knows where those buttons are. We couldn't seem to overcome those slips, those ways of hurting each other, and it seemed to grow in intensity over the years. The truth is, my marriage ended with the admission of an affair, and I had to really look at the buildup of distance, lack of healthy communication, and the way we were blaming and resenting each other. This was all sort of building the distance where the affair even happened in the first place. Now, I've had clients and I've known friends who found their way through an affair. That wasn't our experience. And I think it was just because the relationship itself wasn't on healthy ground. And so the affair for me was that final straw that I was able to take the courage to say, I can't do this anymore. This doesn't feel okay anymore. Which is where I really stood in this place of, here I am in the unknown, ready for reinvention. And so letting go of the idea that it was a failure was a big part of that, being able to move forward from the perspective of what have I learned about myself in love, in heartbreak, in the actual separation. Sort of these three different sections of getting through this whole heartbreak. On the other side of that, there was a lot of self-reflection. There was some time in therapy. There were some great books. There was a lot of time in nature. For me, that really helps to replenish. And there was a new dedication to time on my yoga mat, time with eyes closed in meditation, really giving to myself a lot of the things that were missing inside of our marriage that had a lot of dysfunctional parts. So being able to do that, being able to give myself the love that I was really longing for in our relationship, was a big part of that reinvention. And I want to share with you the work that I was able to do on myself in understanding my loving patterns and some of the painful pieces that I was bringing into this relationship. Let's just call it my half of the dysfunction, led me into the work I'm doing today. Supports me in understanding how complicated love can get. Those were some of my reflections and some of the ways I was able to move through the pain of divorce. What I'm happy to share is that it led me to this extremely fulfilling career where I've been working with couples in distress for almost 2 decades, but I bring with me an understanding of how complicated love can get, how much we can actually hurt the one we love based on what's unresolved in our own family of origin, in our own history of love that went sideways. Without being able to include that, we kind of stay stuck, same arguments, the same hurts, the same resentments just being recycled over and over and over again. So by understanding my part, I was able to get free of the dynamic inside of that relationship. I was actually able to find a partner that was a much better fit for my values and the way that I see the world. And we've been together for, gosh, over 16 years in a healthy, easy way of relating. And so there is hope on the other side. When we do our work in understanding what we bring to that relationship, not only are we much less likely to recreate it with the next partner, but we understand ourselves on a much deeper level. And this supports healthy boundaries with good, sincere friendships. This supports the way we show up with our own kids. We're clearing so many patterns when we can start to heal that part inside of the relationship breakdown. And now you've got a breakthrough.